Alright. I'm going to try out 4 hounds here. I've already bound my controller. MegaMan. Okay, interesting. Alright. Automatic slide, right. Let's see what you guys have here. Okay, so just noting that this is my non-gaming computer, and if I'm looking at OBS while I'm playing, it slows down a bit. Since OBS is currently hidden, the game is running smoother. I'm noticing a small freeze when I either get hit or pick up an item. Now that's likely just on my end. I honestly thought I would get that jump. How much damage output is a full charge shot giving out anyway? Yeah. Did I give that beak 2 full shots? That seems a bit much. I like how you can rock the Joe's back with the shots. you're back, huh? Mad grinder down. Lights Lab. Looks like all the robot masters are in that bubble. Want it to do that much damage? Jeez. I'm happy that it's easy, but that contact damage is a bit much, huh? Okay, anyway, intro level down. All right. Okay, and then here's these. All righty. Static. Okay. Scorch. Smirk. Okay. Yeah, I remember doing some helping out on a little bit of artwork for this guy. I made an icon or something out of him. Well, I guess I'll start with him. Alright. Looks neat. Interesting background. Where am I supposed to be? Las Vegas? Interesting take on a Pippi. Okay, I wasn't expecting that. And they do a lot of damage. What are these? Two hit? Well, I'm noticing the first problem is the contact damage. So this guy's name is Smirk Man. It looks like gambling take... Jesus Christ! Okay. What is the theme of this boss meant to be, exactly? I have no idea what that even was. And Rush can be heard as well. Oh, great. Is there even enough time to get up there? Yeah, I know I'm just taking hits at this point. So yeah, what is this stuff supposed to be? Sewage? Okay, so don't fire on those guys. Poker chips make you fall, okay. Okay, an enemy I clearly cannot hit. Am I supposed to jump on him? Yes. And if I take too long... What the... Okay. Interesting. Some nice original enemies. Trying to remember, if you destroy the Pippi, does it one of the original games, does it still drop the egg? Because in this case, regardless of what you do, that block of cards, deck of cards, is coming down. Rather wild enemy. That's dropping poker chips now. Okay, where am I here? What hit the poker chip? Alright. That's rather annoying. Oh Lord, you're actually gonna... Is that a checkpoint? I sure hope it is. How do you get up there, and do I want to be up there? Okay, I wasn't expecting that. That was rude, but at the same time, hilarious. I like that the number of on the dice or whatever that the Pippi is carrying indicates how many cards will come out and fly at you. Okay, so these platform enemies will shoot the balls at us. Gotcha. And yes, we can destroy them. That Joe is very annoying. It's all timing. Okay, what's your gimmick? You're currently throwing dollar bills. You don't do anything else? That room. Okay, so I either get a bolt, a mega tank, or the two enemies attack me, I assume. I lost. Three smirk men give me a loss. Okay, and I get hit. Oh Lord. Okay, so it's just smoke. Okay, I gotta get used to that ball. My fault. Okay. Okay, let's try to do this correctly. Oop. And I'm already down to nothing. It's my fault for taking all those sewage hits. Curious if these particular enemies have any purpose on these blocks, because all they do is hinder your, you know, advancement. They don't actually attack, they're just in the way. Okay. Once more. Okay, I didn't see that one last time. Ugh. Yeah, I can... There's a lot happening with that boss. The smoke I now understand. The fact that you have to get shocked by the ground pound. It is an ingenious boss. Okay, let's see where I can get with the other two and maybe come back. I'm guessing that there's no major correlation here on weakness. Switches. Okay. These make a comeback as well for Mega Man 3. Just as annoying. Now, I'm already assuming those are death spikes above me. Way. Dead already. Let me check on that damage as we go along. So, the design in the background, is that meant to look like a Pikachu tail? Because I like it. Party this way. Okay. Are these force beams? And are those spikes? My fault. I guess where I'm back again, yeah. So, like I was saying, are the above death spikes as well? Aha! All right. Are these darker ones right in front of me also spikes? Yeah. Yeah, I could use that. Anything that has to bounce higher. No lives again, of course. Call? What is call? How do I get out of here right now? Got a one up. Okay. Nice look. I love the background here. Okay. All right. Okay. Okay, I'm guessing that's an exit area then. Probably from the fire path. Okay. There's a hell of a lot going on in this stage. I honestly thought those blocks underneath were capable of being stood on. Cat is bothering me. See, once you've been in an area once or twice, you can pretty much understand how to get through there. Thank you. fairly easy. Can you stand on that? She can. Ooh. Okay. Yeah, I probably should have seen that one coming. Man, once again, okay, stage is going quite well, let's continue. Okay. You can take damage so quickly on the simplest little mistakes. Thank you. When I died, did you notice how there was like a gap in the lava that then reasserted itself after? Little graphical glitch there. Whoa. Okay. I'm sure I'm going to get it, but do you guys not find that area to be a little too obnoxious? Excuse the burping. Like, I almost feel like this. Like, obviously, if this is here, you're intending for some kind of robot master weapon to be used earlier in the stage. And, yeah, maybe it does belong there. Okay. I'm trying to figure out how to. Maybe it's the fact that I can't shoot through the fire. If you could shoot through the rotating fireballs, that would probably make that section easier. Like, you have fire that's going at two different speeds. Not again. Okay. Where I am again, yeah. It's a good thing that mini boss is easy. But now I have to ask, why wasn't the cigar smoking mini boss in the other stage easier? This dragon is too easy. Regardless of the fact that, yes, I just died to it. Only because I'm not paying attention to the green flame that was under me. Let's put it this way. You can't shoot through the fire. You can't shoot through the arrow. It's fairly annoying, I'm just saying. I'm finally back here. It only took forever. I'm glad that the chandelier can destroy the enemy. Just as a general proof of concept. Here again. Thank you. The less I need of right now are those dragons. And this. Lord. Need to have that many that go. Oh, that took a lot. I do like, though, that the one with the arrows can affect the one with the axe. What? Oh, for God's sake. Even the debris hurts. Okay, another? See, once you know what you're doing, that guy isn't that bad. So if it's necessary to disregard my earlier comments on that particular enemy, you can. But you must admit that that particular area is kind of hectic. I kinda wish there was an item here. Like, I get that it's for the enemy to stand on when you come in the room, but I don't know, there should be something in this room. And yeah, I understand that technically I just said that, but here's a weapon energy. Again, what weapon are you guys intending for people to use prior in? Yes, please, thank you. Of course, I'm naturally immediately hit by the damn fire. Or small ones. Okay. Whoa. Okay, so interesting to introduce a brand new enemy this late in the stage. However, I understood what that enemy was. It was a new variation on one of Magma Man's, Okay, I saw something coming. Ooh, something's about to happen in front of me. Whoa! Okay. That sprays in multiple directions? Okay. And because you go down the ladder as you do, oy. Okay, again, just saying, that's a lethal combination. Now, how do I want to put this? You're introducing a brand new enemy, but instead of it being on its own, it's being introduced alongside a prior enemy. This ladder could be a problem when you're trying to slide around, so you may accidentally reset the room like I did. And, like, here I am just after the checkpoint, and I've already lost more than half of my health. I feel like that fire enemy should be introduced alone. Okay. Also, for the sake of saying, that enemy, the fire enemy, when it's at its lowest point, or should I probably say at either point, the original was based on a shield attacker, was it not? Because you could only attack them from the rear, as far as I remember. This appears to be the same basic enemy, yet you can attack it from the front. Yeah, I'm safe here, so let's examine this thing. This is clearly the enemy from Mega Man 9. Its head is essentially a fire-based shield attacker. So I shouldn't be able to hit this thing from the front. I'm also not sure if I agree with the fact that this thing can fire diagonally as well. Forward I get. Maybe downward I get, but the fact that it's on the bottom level and can still hit me above is rather annoying. You are protecting an E-tank, I see. And that was an idiotic move. And again, my fault, not taking that into consideration. I can't save? Can't save from the game over screen. Okay. Shop. Home. Ah. An hour five. Okay. more lives. Well, this is a crazy bunch of stages, I can tell you that much. Let's see here. Would you say they're not a bit on the long side? Like, I haven't been counting screens, but the fact that you do have two checkpoints so far per stage. Like, these are bordering on unlimited. Okay. Let's try going back to Smirk. Can I make a suggestion that those cards maybe give off more items? Like, the average Pippi was known to give off quite a few, energies and such. Maybe those cards should do the same. Since I'm not getting a whole lot in the way of item drops from a lot of these enemies to begin with. Having those dice cards do something might be just a little extra. Oh, goody. Well, one life down already. I'm also going to go ahead and ask, what is the ratio on drops? Like, on average, what is your percentage chance of getting a 1-up, for example, for defeating an enemy? Like, 1%, 2%, something like that? I don't know. See how many of these cards I'm destroying, and yet I'm getting no items. It's a bit much. Okay, so at present, this is the worst room of all three stages, I think. Not counting mini bosses. The fact that you can bonk your head so easily, and there's these pits we have to deal with. So yeah, I can knock this and do that. Crazy. Yeah, again, I kind of wish I had some kind of a health pickup. I shouldn't have done that. I keep thinking that when I destroy the Pippi, it will, the egg will simply disintegrate. In this case, no. Okay, so I have to be that guy and give another question. In Scorch's stage, I can't shoot through the fire, yet here I can clearly shoot through the liquid. What is your law of physics on what you can and can't shoot through? Like, fire is not a solid. Again, I just shot 6 cards, or dice. Whatever you're going to call them, and a small energy, weapon energy, finally, out of all that. There should be higher energy drops overall. Just saying. Okay. Now for this mini-boss again. Okay. Ground pounding, smoke, sewage or whatever it is. Like, what is this stuff? Sewage, cola? I get that I'm supposed to be, like, in a casino or something. Although the stage doesn't feel like one. Even though there are a number of enemies designed around one. Really want to do this. I want to get past this damn mini boss. After all that, that's all that you give us. Sorry for the complaint. You know, that's plenty. Large energy, a couple of bolts, I like it. It's just the frustration talking there. Okay. Okay, this thing again. Thank you. ricochets. Of course it does. Okay, so these are collapsing chips. Here's another question. Is there an ice boss coming up that freezes this liquid? Huh. Alright. Yeah, I guess Rush Jet would be nice right about now. Whoa. Right. The ones with the white on the top collapse. Another E-Tank. Yes. We're going to ignore that. A bouncer? And I'm down to one health. A large health being right there would be kind of nice. Do you even have a shot at getting that? I'm curious. Like sliding in and out before something goes wrong. Franticness. That one got me. Hearing any sound, it's my damn cat. That's on fault of cat. Finally, she stops. Okay, so does it hurt to just touch them? Yes. However, touching them doesn't activate them. Interesting. Interesting. I like it. Did I finally reach a boss? Oh no. That's too frantic. So I have to deal with the bouncer that's absolutely crazy in his own right. the drunken Joe that can somehow throw beer or whatever alcohol directly above or below me. Meanwhile, I have a collapsing poker chip I can't stand on. And the one throwing the money directly in front of it. Like, you think you have a safe spot being in the top left and assessing what you're doing, but no, the Joe can hit you from there. So you're forced to go below. The whole thing is a bit much. Especially, again, considering how much damage can be dealt so quickly. All right. I am going to, for now, save. I'm aware that I could have just left it the way it was, yeah. Okay, I think we're gonna stop here for now, because I've been going for quite a while. And I might pick this up again, try a second attempt. I don't know if you guys can use any feedback from what I've done. But I'll upload and we'll see what happens.